just a reminder, anyone who has a pyx to bring communion to someone after Mass, please bring your pyx up and leave it at the altar at this time. You can be called up after Mass to receive your pyx along with a blessing. Thank you.
Our liturgy this morning will begin with our entrance antiphon, which is number on page 39, right before the scripture readings in your hymnal. I'll sing it the first time, and then we'll sing it together the second time. Our Advent candle will be lit, and then we'll join in singing our gathering song, which is the Advent Litany, number 64.
Good and gracious God, be with us as we try to change our lives to be better able to accept your love into our hearts. May that love shine like this candle to all we deal with this week.
Mercy,
Alleluia.
Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Christ Jesus, coming in glory, your kingdom brings rejoicing. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, coming in glory, your kingdom casts out fear. Christ, have mercy.
See how your people faithfully await the feast of the Lord's Nativity. Enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation, and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Shout for joy, O daughter of Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear not, O Zion, be not discouraged. The Lord, your God, is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you, as one sings at festivals. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Cry out to me.
Sing praise to the Lord for his glorious achievement. Let this be known throughout all the earth. Shout with exultation, O city of Zion, for great in your midst is the Holy One of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your request known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Soldiers also asked him, "And what is it that we should do?" He told them, "Do not practice extortion, do not falsely accuse anyone, and be satisfied with your wages." Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, "I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you. These words of the prophet, originally spoken to a people defeated, dejected, grieving and in exile, seem even to us today strange. You get the sense that they speak of a kind of love and joy that God has when he looks upon his people, that his people don't even have for themselves. This Sunday is known as Gaudete Sunday, because of the very first word of the Mass in Latin, the first word of the entrance antiphon. It's translated as rejoice. But Gaudete in Latin, it's a command, a plural command. So as they would say in the South, all y'all rejoice. But it can be difficult to hear such a command very often. When I wake up in the morning and there's some new kind of pain, or when those worries that were there as we fell asleep, they're there to greet us first thing as we open our eyes. When the pain of loss is still there. When the nervousness or the anxiety about some threat we or a loved one is facing is ever present. When we are down on ourselves and we've been defeated, for those of us who are in the working world, maybe it's when things at work are really going poorly and we can see the handwriting on the wall and we know there might not be a place for us in our current job much longer. For those of us who are students, when you have that big test coming up or the big test already happened and it didn't go so well. Those are moments when to hear that command to rejoice is exceptionally difficult. And I don't know about you, but I don't think in my whole life I have ever looked at myself in the mirror and been moved to song. And yet, this is precisely what the prophet says will happen when God looks at us. What a curious thing. We face another bit of difficulty as well, because our contemporary American culture tells us that in order to be happy, well, you've got to put suffering out of your life. So if you just buy this product, or take this pill, or get into this relationship, or do this activity, you'll be happy because your body will feel better, or you'll have a certain status and prestige, or you will be fashionable, and so on and so on. And to be fair, there is a certain novelty and a certain excitement that we get from new things and satisfying basic needs. For those of you who might not be really going down rabbit holes in the internet, I'll just inform you. There's actually a whole genre of internet video called unboxing videos. Somebody will go out and they'll get a brand new product, and the whole video is just them opening it up for the first time. And there are millions of such videos. Yeah, you get the latest version of the iPhone. It's kind of fun. You see its new features. And then a week later, a month later, or when the next one comes out, it's, oh, that old thing. And such is the way with absolutely everything that the world offers us. There's nothing that this world offers us that we can sort of lay our hands on or sink our teeth into that we can count on to make us happy, not only in this moment, but by the end of today, and the end of next week, and next month, and the year, and for the rest of our lives. It's just not the way it works. Especially not in the face of all of the loss and the change that we endure as we go through life. The loss of our health, the loss of our strength, maybe the loss of our intellect, the loss of loved ones, the loss of money. But the world gets it wrong fundamentally in this. Happiness or joy, it is not something that we experience in spite of our sufferings. It's something we experience precisely because of it. It's something that we experience as a fruit of the Holy Spirit because of the salvation that God extends to us, offers us, wants for us. That is a salvation that is not encumbered by suffering, grief, disappointment, loss, rejection, dejection. It is a kind of joy and a kind of salvation that brings us up out of all of those things and longs to exalt us. So you see, what is offered to us is not merely a kind of an existence that, well, we won't have pain anymore, or we won't have loss anymore. What is really offered to us is an experience such that no matter how much pain we have endured or currently endure, no matter how much loss we have suffered, God plans to restore us. God plans to heal us. No matter how bad we have sinned, because we have wandered away from the truth and we've really bought into all of these false winds on which the culture will sell us, no matter how badly we've wounded ourselves or our relationships through our pursuit of an addiction, no matter how deeply we have sinned, God offers us a way back from it all. And God's plan for us is to raise us up. Raise us up so high. Give us such an exalted position that when He will look upon us, He will be so moved by our beauty, our goodness, our nobility, that He will break into song. That, my brothers and sisters, is the good news. That is the cause of our joy. That something is offered to us that no matter how badly we might suffer, when we finally get to enjoy what God offers, there will be no doubt it was more than worth it. That's true joy. And that's a joy that nothing can ever take away again. And so I ask, with this knowledge, how ought we to look? Consider even physically, as we walk out of the doors of this church this moment, or those of you viewing online, as you get up from watching this and you go on to your next thing, what should your physical posture be? What should the expression on your face be? What should the tone in your voice be? May we go forth from here in the power of the Spirit, armed with this great knowledge of the wondrous things God promises us, and live in such a way that it is palpable, that it is obvious to everyone we encounter. Maybe there was really some point to what these people did here for this last hour. Peace be with all of you this day, and with all who love the Lord in simplicity of heart. And in peace, let us continue our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
For the Church, that in the face of hardships and persecution, there may still be rejoicing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those affected by the pandemic, may they be enlightened and enlivened by the Holy Spirit's healing power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
My sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice of our worship, Lord, we pray, be offered to you unceasingly, to complete what was begun in sacred mystery, and powerfully accomplish for us your saving work, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God, our Lord, and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Take the most holy body and blood of the Son to our brethren and God to be with us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. We implore your mercy, Lord, that this divine sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feasts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For those of you who have been wondering about extended times for the sacrament of reconciliation for Advent, immediately following this Mass next week, Father Kyle will be available for confessions, and I will be available immediately following the 11 a.m. Mass in Haynes Falls. So as soon as we finish the Mass and greet those who want to leave, we will be available for confessions, and we will remain here for as long as people continue coming. So however long that requires. So if you know that you want to be able to come for that, but you wouldn't be able to get here until noon, or if you know somebody else who does, then tell them to go out and find about a dozen or so sinners to come and keep me occupied or keep Father Kyle occupied until the day can arrive. And of course, as always, we are available by appointment. Don't be shy. Call us, call the office, say, hey, you don't want to come by for confession, and we'll work it out. I am resisting as yet setting a regular time in the schedule because the schedule is still in flux, with one exception. We have reinstituted the First Friday devotion. So every Friday at 6:30 p.m. there's a Mass at the Shrine, and on First Fridays Following that, there'll be exposition, evening prayer, and about an hour of adoration and confessions. So that's already been reinstituted, and eventually there will be something on a schedule, probably weekly, just not yet. But next week, following both 11 a.m. Masses, Father Kyle and I will each be available for as long as is required for confessions. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you,
the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.